So I've got a game here called Kingdom Corps, and Kingdom Corps is a card game. Well, at least you assume it is, until you have a look at what's going on. So you've got your basic world select there to start off with. Now, that didn't really look like a card game, did it? You've got your map or city or town or whatever you want to call it. And you've got a bit of a production going on. I've got a field to earn me gold. I've got a warehouse to store the gold. I've got a house to accommodate people. Got a weapon shop. So there's a lot of things going on here that don't really resemble a card game, and it's a very complex game. So you start off, you've got your town sitting on a map shared with other players. Sorry, get out of that one. So that's my town. But you've also got these other alliances that are spread out throughout the map. You've got ranks for the land. Obviously the land with some crystals on it is worth a little bit more than a land with nothing on it. And of course the difficulty of taking land increases with the level of that land. Now I can deploy my troops to invade or defend land as required. And my troops are where the card game comes in. Basically I have a deck of cards. From that deck of cards I can form units. And the idea is to acquire more powerful cards, to upgrade them by merging them with other cards, to level up their skills, to send them to dungeons to increase their experience. You can purchase troops for each card to increase their odds in battle. There's a lot of things involved here. So they have this thing called Lotto. Lotto is basically where you get your cards from. You can use CP, which is a currency that's... you can use real life money to get it. CP will give you normally quite rare cards, so I'll use an example here. And you can see there what the status are. You can tell already it's a rare card. And then I'll just draw another one from the cheapo random. And I've got a level C bat, so C is not that great, but yeah, it doesn't really matter too much. Now what I'll do now is head over to my deck, and I'll check out those two cards I just acquired. So there's my bat. Not that great. You can have a look at its attributes. If you're into the artwork, you can have a look at that. You can recruit troops for that, which does require mana, and mana you acquire in your towns. And you can have a look at what skills it has available. Now you can fuse cards together. So if I take this card, which I just recently acquired, that's the rare card just then. Let's say I wanted to fuse this bat to it. We go for basic fusion. And what it does is increase the power of the first card. And it sacrifices the second card, it destroys it. So so now that card is slightly more powerful. You can actually have a look at its stats to get an idea of just how more powerful it has become. So I've got a few cards here, a few rare ones and a few common ones, but I've only just started, so there's obviously a long way to go. Cards have attributes, think Pokemon, like water beats fire, that type of thing. Now, when you start off, you don't really have any idea of what to do. You're kind of motivated by quests. Quests will guide you throughout the beginning of the game, just to give you an idea of what you can do and how to do it. So this is just basic stuff to strengthen a card, which I've already done, to raise the level of a weapon shop, which I've already done, raise a castle to level 4, I've already done that one. So if you've already done a quest and the quest's there waiting, you can accept the quest and you immediately complete it, so you don't have to redo anything. You gain gold mana and KP. KP is used for purchasing more cards. And if you receive too many rewards, you'll need to upgrade your warehouse in order to store them. So I'm going to cancel that one for now. So I've covered the quests, I've covered Lotto, I've covered Fusion. You've got duels. You can send your teams into duels to help increase their experience. So in this case, my team's recovering from an earlier battle where they took over a piece of land, so they're not faring too well at the moment. But if I were to duel this guy, I'd say we're about even. So I might, yeah, why not? We'll tap the screen, we'll go next, we'll see what happens. So it's as simple as that. It's automatically calculated, there's no fancy battle animations. It's just basically, it's based on stats. If your stats are higher than theirs, chances are you're going to win. Now, you've got dungeons as well. It's, again, there's no fancy animations, it's all text-based. You can send your characters to dungeons to gain experience. With more experience, their abilities level up and they get stronger. It makes sense. There's timers on the dungeons. When you send them there, they have to spend a certain amount of real-life time exploring, and then they'll come back when they're done with their rewards. They may have to recover a little bit after they've been sent to a dungeon. You have this morale bar. If the morale is down, you have to wait for it to recover until they can do more dungeons. You've got a guild system. I haven't looked into that too much, but I believe you can ally yourself with others to help attack lands together and whatnot. It's a more efficient way of doing things. You've got a mail system, which you can mail other players, and you can get daily mail from the game creator to kind of find out what's going on. You've got rankings in this game, so obviously the higher ranked players will show up towards the top, and you can have a look at who's doing better in your piece of land. You can compare yourself to your other guild players as well. You've got your profile, which shows what rank you are, how much land you own, that type of thing. And of course, the main highlight of this game, the cash store. So everything's, well, not everything, some things are driven by cash. If you want the rare cards, you know, you might have to shuffle through 20 odd dodgy cards before you get one good one. Whereas with this CP system, you can pretty much guarantee yourself a good card straight away. You can get some advantages, like increase the amount, increase the quality of cards you can hold in a, what do you call it, hold on 1 second. In a unit. So you'll see here on the bottom left hand side there's a cost. I can only spend 25 points at the moment between my two units. I can unlock a third unit later on. What that means is if I put in some quality cards like this one, its cost is 5. That means I can only hold 5 by 5, 25, so 5 of these cards across 9 slots. That's obviously not a efficient way of managing your units. It's rather, or it's better to have low cost cards mixed in with some high cost cards, just to give you an overall balance. You'll probably end up with a more powerful team anyway. Anyway, this is only the beginning of this game, there's a hell of a lot to it. It's taken me a couple of days just to get my head around it. So it's definitely worth checking out. So that's Kingdom Corps. Feel free to leave a comment down below if you want to learn more.